Jesus will fix it. Thank you, Lord, for being a fixer. You will fix it.
Encouraging us this day. Right now, Lord,
Make sure we
some stuff.
I like that.
Somebody say, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Now I'm gonna handle my stuff. I ain't gonna try to handle you. You handle your stuff. Don't try to handle your neighbor's. You just handle your stuff. And I'll handle my stuff. And we'll both be better off. A wife can't be the wife she ought to be if her house is toxic. Husband can't be who he ought to be if his house is toxic. A friend can't be a good friend if his house is toxic. But when I look at this text, I say, wow, what a word from the Lord. The Lord is writing to the people of Israel, a stubborn people, but yet he sends them good news. Who would serve a God like that? You find these folks at this particular time, they were not doing what thus said the Lord. They were doing whatever they wanted to do.
Now say that.
They were caught up in their own ways. In Isaiah 42, you don't have to go far to find out how bad off they were. If you look at chapter 42, verse 18, you'll see that the Lord has said, listen, my folks are stubborn. Y'all know any stubborn folks?
Oh, yeah.
Have you looked in the mirror lately?
Amen.
I know every time I look in there, I see somebody who need a whole lot of work. There's something about us that is hard sometimes to follow.
That's right.
We don't mind leading. We don't mind telling other folks to follow me. But when it comes to following, we are some stubborn folks. We got it honestly. We got it from the Israelites. You see, we all got the same dad and the same mom. We all go back to Adam and Eve. Listen to what the Lord said. He said, hear ye deaf, and look ye blind that ye may see. Who is blind but my servant? Or deaf as my messenger that I sent. He said, even my servant and my messenger got it all messed up. Seeing many things, but they don't observe. Their ears are open, but they don't hear. The Lord says in verse number 21, he is well pleased for his righteousness' sake that he will magnify the law and make it honorable so that we might see our sin and our wickedness. He goes on to say, who gave Jacob for a spoil? And Israel to the robbers, did not the Lord? He against whom we have sinned. See, every time you sin against the Lord. For he said, for they would not walk in his way, and neither were they obedient unto his law. Isn't it something that nestled in their stubbornness, nestled in their fickleness, nestled in their idolatry, God sends a word of good news.
Yes,
he says to them in Isaiah 43:18, he said, hey, listen, I want you to remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing, and it shall spring forth.
Thank you.
It shall spring forth. It, what is it? It's a new thing. Somebody under the sound of my voice right now, you need God to do a new thing. God said, I will do a new thing in your family. I will do a new thing on your job. I'll do a new thing in your marriage. I'll do a new thing in your body. I'll do a new thing in your mind. If only you would believe me. Whatever it is, the Lord is saying that you need that, it shall spring forth. You need healing in your body, he can do it. You need healing in your heart, he can do it. It shall spring forth. It, the new thing that you need. Shall is a word that carries with it the notion of a promissory note.
That's right.
That God has made a promise that he will surely do it. That he signed it with his blood. You can count on it. You can take it to the bank. It shall. And he says, spring, in other words, it will suddenly leap forward, it will advance in your life.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, man, it shall come into view. So he said, it shall spring forth. Listen to what he says. He said, I don't even want you to remember these former things. Neither consider things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing and it shall spring forth. And I began to wonder, Lord, how and why shall it spring forth? And the Lord began to share with me some insight that just blew me away. First of all, the Lord said, it shall spring forth because I've made a decision to love and save my people.
All right.
In other words, it wasn't because of any goodness of your own. It wasn't because you search and search and search until I found the Lord. No. It is because God made a decision to love us unconditionally, not based on anything that we would do. And he began to show them in the early verses. And chapter number 43, listen to verse number 1. He said, but now, thus said the Lord that created thee, O Jacob. And you know, Jacob was a mess. He was a trickster. Jacob was a liar. He was always scheming. But the Lord said, even to you, Jacob, I want you to remember that I'm the God that created you. And I'm the one who formed thee into Israel. In other words, when you were just a mess, I didn't give up on you. I kept right on loving you until I changed your name to Israel. I stayed with you when you didn't want to do right. I know I'm talking to somebody. When you didn't even want to come into the house of the Lord. When you didn't even want to serve the Lord. When you wanted to do everything that you were big and bad enough to do. I didn't give up on you because I am your God. And I made a decision a long time ago before you came forth in your mother's womb that I would love you and I would pull you out of the darkness and into the marvelous light. I'm talking to somebody.
All right, yeah.
He said, I'm the one who formed you into being Israel. And listen to what the Lord said. He's talking to somebody right now. He said, fear not. I don't care what's going on in your life. I know you may have a doctor's appointment. Maybe you got a pink slip. Maybe your money is running a little short. Maybe you're just afraid because you don't know what's going to happen on tomorrow. The Lord God Almighty said, fear not.
Thank you, Lord.
He said, for I have redeemed thee. I paid a price for your soul. I sent my son to die on Calvary's cross. He said, I called thee by thy name. And the Lord said, you are mine.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody ought to say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
I don't even know why you love me so, God. But thank you that you claim me as your own.
Yes, that's right.
The Lord goes on to tell them that, yeah, I know you're stubborn. I know you're all that. I know I'm the one who created you. But I want you to know that even when you pass through the waters,
speak to me.
I will be with thee, and through the rivers they shall not overflow thee, and even when you walk through the fire. See, the Lord didn't say he would keep you from the waters or the rivers or the fire, but he promised never to leave us nor to forsake us. He said, whatever you go through in life, I'll be right there with you. He said, you can walk through the fire and not be burned, and neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Oh, what a great and awesome God we serve. He said, you were precious in my sight, not by what you're doing right now, but when I look on the other side of Calvary, when I look through the blood of my son Jesus, when I look through the eyes of sanctification, and I saw what you would become on tomorrow, I began to get excited for you. I sent your word to hold on and hold out, because whatever you need from me, it shall spring forth. Good God Almighty, I kept right on reading and I found out it shall spring forth because the Lord said in verse number 10 that I have chosen you. When I think about it, my mind almost gets blown. When I think about the mess that I am, and I hear the Lord say, I chose you. I said, Lord, you're a mighty good God. Thank you for your tender mercies. Thank you for your grace. In other words, God is saying, I looked over your faults and I met your every need. You got some strength that I gave you, and I know the weaknesses that you have, but I sent your word to let you know that down in your weaknesses is where my strength is perfected. Help me, Holy Ghost. He said it shall spring forth because I've made a decision to love you and to save you. It shall spring forth because I have chosen you. And he says you shall be my witnesses. Good God Almighty, the Lord said, I'm going to look over your faults. I'm going to meet your need. I'm going to meet your need called salvation. I'm going to meet your need called sanctification. I'm going to change you into a different person. And the folks around you are going to know that there's a God who sits high and looks low. Not because of what you did, but because of what I did through you and for you. I wish I had a witness of somebody who knows that God has been good to you. Don't act like you always had it together. Don't act like you haven't made some mistakes. Don't act like God has had to help you out in the midnight hour. When times get hard, I want somebody to know that God said, you. Stop trying to figure it out and just